welcome to Marshalls Park School. You will find that coming to a large secondary school is rather different from your primary school. And we're putting together this video in order to show you some of the changes that you will have to undertake when you become a pupil of a secondary school. Marshalls Park is rather different to other secondary schools, inasmuch that apart from being the best school, it's also a school on two different sides. That is, pupils from the age of 11 to 14 attend the lower school in Pettit's Lane, and after the age of 14 they move to upper school in Havering Drive and remain there until the ages of 16 when they leave school or when they go into the sixth form. I'm sure you will enjoy watching this video, because it's going to be very helpful for you learning something about how to find your way around the building, what sort of classrooms you'll be working in, what sort of equipment you're going to have to use. I'm sure you're going to enjoy your visit to the school and when you become a pupil in September.
yet, but obviously we need to know what's going on. Now, on Wednesday, this is the day for your class activities. Now, sure, so your form tutors will have mentioned this to you. All your classes will be doing different things depending on what your form tutors would like you to do. Some people are going to Hampton Court, some people are going to Morden, some are going bowling, some may be going somewhere else, some may be staying in school. Depends on what your form tutor would like you to do. Now, the morning session is going to be split into two. So you'll do one type of activity in the first half, do some kind of break, and then you'll change activities at the break time. As a group, you are going to be split into two. Now, depending on which group you're in, depends on which way round you're going to do certain activities. One group will go into the youth centre and do a quiz, which will last about an hour and a half. The other group will do approximately... the election campaign, books versus television, that you've been working on now for a few weeks. In order for people watching the video to understand what's going on, then we'd like to explain what we've been doing. Okay, Simon.
Yeah, well, firstly, I'm reading this book called Twilight Chocolate Factory, and it's a bit about Roald Dahl saying about Roald Dahl TV movies, like making your life to happen, and good books on.
Okay, right, so we read that first of all, an extract from Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, and we looked at how he said that books were best and television made your eyes pop out and things like that. And you're in two teams. Over here, we've got the team who are saying that books aren't as good as television. Books aren't as good as television. Over here, we've got the team that says the opposite, that says really what Roald Dahl said, that television isn't as good as books. Okay? So then what did we do? Once you were in your teams, then what did we do?
We made booklets to look at these pages and then we just put it all together and now we're going to do a big poster.
Okay, so you're onto your posters. You've done the booklet, say, as if you're going to put these out to people, to say how your idea is best, okay, for your side, that books are best, okay, and now you're on your posters. Okay, now today you've got the whole of today's lesson to work on your posters. Remember, it's to say, if you're on this side, that books are best. If you're on this side, that television is best. And if you manage to finish, you can get on to doing your speech. It's got to be a 5-minute speech. It can be a piece of drama. It can be acting out your ideas. Okay, but 5 minutes, and it's going to be shown to another first year class and they're going to vote. Any questions before we start? Okay, off you go then. Thank you.
shop. All right. And I want somebody to come properly. Okay, so what you're going to do now is you've got to do a scene with a shop assistant and somebody working the shop that leads to bad feeling, a disagreement. Think about it like this. It doesn't have to be as we did it. It could be somebody accused of shoplifting. Make it as believable as possible. You often get disagreements in shops. What kind of things could you get disagreements about in shops? Yeah? You know, there might be a dent in it, it's the only one left.
Am I not supposed to give you like a stack of cans on or something like that?
My friend and I recently went in to get some wine. And you know those big trolleys? Yeah, I told you, you know?
Yeah.
The trolley, I forgot to do. No, I didn't knock it over. You know there's a back to it, back to a trolley you put down the baby sitting in. We didn't pull that down. So we've got the bottle of wine.
Chris, sat down. Let's chat.
No,
Our boy is in third spot, Louise.
Come, sir.
Our boy is like, put it away. Good boy.
Like that, pull it down.
Have a watch that.
Take it. Now pay.
Just pretend he's going to do it.
Yes, sir.
What's been going on, please?
Thank you.
Good.
Good boy.